Hello, this is Manash Patel from IchimokuTrade.com. Today is August 17, 2014. This is our bi-weekly analysis for the global markets, where we cover everything from Europe to Middle East to Asia and then North and South America. Okay, let's begin. We're in our normal procedures. This is our normal disclaimer to state this is for education use only. We're not soliciting you to buy or sell any particular instrument. If you do so, you're doing that at your own risk. All the charts you're going to see are basically from eSignal today on this video. Here is our contact details here, where you can contact us on any of these office locations here, or you can email us here at info@eiicapital.com. You're also able to go to ichimokutrade.com, access any of our free videos. Our scanners, our multiple time frame email alerts, heat maps, and so forth. I really encourage you guys to go to the video section. And then if you go to the navigator, there's a webinar we did on the whole website for all the trading tools that are available. It's under videos. And then if you click on the right hand side on the navigation, it's under heat map email tutorials there. And then you could see a webinar that we did this week to go through our scanners, where you could even set up filtering on our scanners and have a daily report sent to you for a lot of the markets that are out there. Okay, so let's begin and let's go straight to eSignal. Okay, remember on the left hand side is basically the daily time frame, and the right hand side is basically the weekly time frame. All these support resistances here that you see on both the daily and weekly up in the weekly. So you could see all the weekly support resistances here, and then you could see how they look as far as the daily is concerned. This video is more towards the long-term picture. We're trying to give you a forecast of where it's at long-term. That way you can kind of see what's going on there. And you probably have seen some of these videos that I have done, so nothing new. So if you look, we're going to first start off in Europe. We're going to start with Ireland. If you look at Ireland, basically had a nice little trend going up. It's finally gone for its major pullback. The pullback, major pullback level that had needed to support was 59.92. It held it. Now the goal is to get above the major resistance, which is at 64.86. So slowly going up there. There are minor resistances it's going to meet along the way. So it's not going to be a smooth going up to that resistance, but probably a little difficult one. It may decide to consolidate after this pullback, or may just straight to go up. We don't know, because after major pullbacks, either it goes up or it starts to consolidate slowly going up. So we're not quite sure which one this one's going to be, but right now it kind of looks like it may consolidate a little between the 59.92 level and the 64.86 level for at least the next couple of months. So we'll have to see, but slowly this is going up. But it still needs a lot of work to go up, and you could see that from the daily time frame. UK, the FTSE market, you could see this thing is just consolidating. Major support here is 64.49, major resistance is 68.79. Just consolidating between the two, kind of broke down below the middle of the consolidation pattern, came right back up there. So this thing's just going whipsaw back and forth. And you could see that here. However, this is tilted a little more towards the bullish side, as you could see, because it's above the cloud. And slowly, this thing is respecting the top of that cloud going up. So this is still a little more tilted towards the bullish side. So if you are a swing trader or a day trader, I'll still definitely be looking for bullish trades on the lower time frames, because they have a higher probability, but stick to pullbacks to keep your risk low. German index, you could see it's not really consolidating. This was trending here very well, and then the last couple of weeks it decided to go for its first major pullback that it really hasn't had for a long time. The major pullback level, believe it or not, 68.04, kind of fell short of that, which is 89.28. So it still has a high probability getting down to 86.04, at least for the next 3 to 4 weeks. If it gets above this resistance level here, which is at 94.83, then all bets are off on that getting down here. So you can see it where it could bounce off here, come back up to here, this resistance level 84.83, test that, and then start to make a move to come down to 86.04. So really, right now, the critical levels are going to be 86.04 and 94.83 are the major resistance levels. If it decides to stop here and then come back to this resistance level, it could go higher. But German index still is very bullish, believe it or not, but it's just under gauged since first major pullback, which is this move right here. And you could kind of see that because it was a little consolidating here right at the top, and then finally it broke out, but then really didn't sit there and continue to go up. Didn't hold this minor support here at 97.97. It kind of broke down. So when as soon as it closed below that level here, you kind of expected this to possibly engage in a major pullback. And then once it broke 9600, it definitely did. France, you could see here, also going for a major pullback here. We're still doing pairs trading where we're long German market and short Paris market, because the German market is still showing more bullishness than the French market. So we are still long in that trade. And you could see here, same scenario here, the major pullback level is going to be somewhere around here at 40, 44, or roughly around 4,000. There's a couple of supports here depending on when it gets there. And the major resistance level is going to be this guy right there. Let's see, that's kind of hard to see. So let's start increase this. It's going to be about 43.46 is going to be its major resistance level. And then you got a minor one here at 92.75. But basically, it's got a high probability of coming somewhere down here close to 4,000 if it doesn't go up to retest this resistance first and then goes down. But this is under a major pullback, just like the German market. Switzerland, if you look at Switzerland, kind of just consolidating between 81.24 and, believe it or not, 85.91. This is starting to go for a major pullback too, and you could kind of see like the German market broke out and then came back below here. It didn't hold the minor support and broke it. So it does have a high probability of possibly getting here in the next couple of months to about 78.95. But we're at a very critical level right now at this resistance level, 84.03. So the 84.03 is going to tell us if that resistance level holds, this is going to undergo a major pullback where it possibly could get to 8,000 or even down here to 78.95. So we got to watch this next couple of weeks to see exactly what happens at this resistance level. But if it does break this resistance level and starts close to higher, then we do have a possibility of retesting the high and continue on this upward trend to go up. Iceland, here you could see it's still very bullish here. Let me shrink this chart down a little here. Nice little trend here. Did a pullback. Did a major pullback, but it's still a very, very strong pullback, believe it or not, where it does have a possibility of breaking this resistance at 400 and keep on going. The true test is going to be when it comes back here and pulls back up to this support at 387. If it holds that level, if it holds that level and then starts to make a move for 400, there's high probability it's going to break it and keep on going higher. This is still very, very strong bullish, so definitely keep an eye on Iceland moving forward. Baltic is next. If you look at Baltic, we got to our major support at 574, and now we're going to pull back up. This now has changed. This, believe it or not, was bullish and was engaging in a major pullback. Let me shrink this down. You could see here it was bullish here, trending all the way up here and decided to consolidate and then came down here below the cloud. This does not look like a fake breakout to the bottom side. This looks like this will fulfill a downward trend where it's possibly going to reverse to go bearish or enter a consolidation pattern. So definitely keep an eye on this one. Doesn't mean it's going to happen now, but it basically is going to sit there and try to go back up here to this resistance level. And this resistance level is going to be the first little test for this guy it's going to have, which is roughly around 603 level. The next is going to be 610 and then 621. If it gets above 621, the bearish momentum's over and this is going to consolidate between 574 and 621. But we believe what's going to happen is it's going to pull back up here to about 604, 610 area. And then at that point, it'll hold that resistance level, especially at the 610 level. If it holds that resistance level here, it's going to bounce down, come back down here. And at that point, it's going to have a possibility of breaking down. Probably in the next couple of months, you'll see it to possibly start trending downwards. But this is starting to, the bullish momentum has kind of gotten away. And this is now starting to show more signs of basically being bearish. So definitely keep an eye on Baltic region to be bearish for the next couple of months now and start looking for that. Denmark is different. You could see it's a nice bullish trend here. Really has not even gone for a major pullback. It's still very, very strong. Minor resistance level right now is 726. If it holds that 726 resistance level, then this possibly can go for a major pullback, but we won't really know until we break the support here around 685. So Denmark is still very, very strong going forward, but I don't like the idea that we broke out of this resistance here at 726 and then we didn't hold that as a minor support and kept on going. It kind of broke down to the minor support level at 706, which is the next level, but we really haven't broken that next support level, so it's still strong where it possibly could consolidate here, but the more it consolidates, the weaker it's going to get. But this is starting to show some signs of being bearish, which is not good. Finland, this is starting to show some signs of being bearish. It's a little more bearish than Denmark. The same scenario, it still hasn't gone for a major pullback. 7509 is a major resistance level. If it holds that, then it can go for a major pullback. Where possibly, believe it or not, it could come all the way down here to about 6644. So you're definitely going to keep an eye on that one. Norway, you could see here, this is approaching its medium pullback level support at 645. There's not even a sign yet of this going for a major pullback yet. This is very, very similar, believe it or not, as Denmark. So this is still strong. This is a little more stronger than Denmark right now. This is still, until this breaks 645, there's no possibility of a major pullback yet. This is still strong to a point it could bounce off the 645 and continue to go up. So definitely keep an eye on that. But in this region here, Norway definitely looks to be more bullish right now than Denmark, which was opposite in the last couple of months. And now you're starting to see the Baltic index being bearish too. Belgium, this is bullish trending but consolidating here at the top. Major support level is here, 3016. If it breaks that, then it's going to go for a major pullback. If not, it's going to continue to consolidate between 3016 and 3182. Sweden, if you look at Sweden, same scenarios, major trend here. The major resistance level to determine if this is going to go for a pullback is going to be 1368. It's going to be the major resistance to see if this is going to go for a major pullback. There's a high probability it will engage in a major pullback now, just like a lot of the other countries in this region. Netherlands, if you look at Netherlands now, same scenario as all the others. So you basically have bullish trend. It's actually gone for a pullback already. Question is, how far is it going to go? It's already touched the top of the cloud. It could possibly go in it and get to the bottom, which would be about 639. So we kind of have to wait and see. The major resistance level that's going to determine if this is going to continue to go up or to pretty much enter a major pullback is going to be the 404 level resistance level. Spain. Spain right here, this is an ugly consolidation bullish pattern that's being slowly going up. It got to a major support last week, which is about 54.21. It had a possibility of breaking it. It didn't break it at all. Came back up, got to a major resistance level of 55.26. But you could see from the past patterns here, this is going to be one ugly pattern going forward. This is still bullish in nature, but it's very ugly bullish consolidation going up. So be wary on that, and that's kind of Spain. But this is still bullish, believe it or not, and will remain bullish until we break the support level of 54.21, which we haven't. Greece, a lot of people have been talking about that. It's finally gone for its major pullback level. We had 1570 outlined, but it got there faster to this support than we expected. So next minor one was 1515, which it kind of bounced off there and closed above that level, and also 1570, which is our support level that we had outlined. So the major pullback of the Greece market is over. Now the question is, what's going to happen? If it breaks the 1515 level and closes below that, then we're going to have a possibility of a train going the other way or entering a consolidation pattern. But the bullish momentum is pretty much going to be over, and this movement here is not a major pullback. If it comes up to 1767, which is its major resistance level, if it holds it, then it's going to enter a consolidation pattern where the top of the consolidation pattern will be there and the bottom is going to be about 1515. If it breaks it, then we're going to have a high probability of retesting the high and getting to about 2000. So this is one to definitely watch. We are looking to sit there and see this going bullish to about 1767. We're expecting it to, with high probability, to get at least back up to that level, and then we're going to see the true nature of what's going to happen with the Greece market, whether it's going to hold that resistance or break it. Portugal, you could see here, this was going for a major pullback. It actually pulled back too much now to a point the bullish momentum's over, and this is no longer a major pullback. So we're even going to enter a consolidation pattern or a trend reversal. And this, believe it or not, is shaping up to be a trend reversal now. We just need to see a little upward movement where it's going to test some of these resistances. And once we see exactly what resistance it holds, we're going to be able to determine if this is going to be a trend to the bearish side, or this is going to enter a consolidation pattern to go down. I mean, consolidation pattern that's slowly going to deplete, excuse me, and go down. Italy, a lot of people have been talking about Italy here in the US as being bearish. Really, it's not bearish, believe it or not. This is a nice little a bullish trend here, and it's finally engaged in this first major pullback. This pullback is minor, believe it or not. Even though it's a major pullback, it's still not a very strong major pullback. So there's still some bullish momentum in here. Now the question is, what's going to happen in the next couple of months? Is it going to start going into this cloud, or is it going to basically sit there and follow this cloud going up to its major resistance, which is outlined right here? Okay. The chart's not working with me today. And you could see here, this is the major resistance here, which is 20,722. Our probabilities are high right now that this thing is going to sit there and come back up to this resistance level, and at that point it's going to hold and then start making its move all the way back down to get close to about 18,500. So we kind of have to wait and see, but right now we're betting on this thing going up to at least about 20,732, and at that point we want to see exactly what's going to happen here. I know a lot of people are bearish on the Italy market, but be very careful in going bearish because this has still got a lot of momentum to the bullish side and only needs a little more upward movement, and the short sellers are going to get caught, and this is going to get to this resistance level very, very fast. So be very careful in trying to go bearish, especially since it's at a major support. Austria, let's zoom out on this one. Kind of shrink it down, you could kind of see that this is bullish trending, and now it's into an ugly consolidation pattern. Next major support on this trend reversal right here is 2190. This is a nice little trend going down to the other side now, and you could see that here. So you could see that with very confidence here that this is a trend reversal going down. Okay. And that was Austria. Next is Czechoslovakia. You can see Czechoslovakia is not doing anything, just consolidating right now. This is a little more to the bearish side, but it is a consolidating, but it's to the bearish side, and you can see the support resistance is outlined. Nothing really much to talk about there. Hungary, here, not really much going on here. This is consolidating between 16,105 and 19,589. It basically held the middle right here. It's trying to go down to the bottom. So this is bearish as far as the consolidation pattern is concerned, trying to get to the bottom. Poland here, really not doing anything here. The support's been holding. The resistances have been going lower, lower, lower. So there's a squeeze play going on in Poland right now, but no telling which way this is going to sit there and end up. But slowly it looks like it's trying to hammer out and break the support to go down, but hasn't had any success yet. Romania, you could see it's a nice little bullish trend going up, still strong going up, consolidating here a little at the top, but this is still very strong here to a point it could easily get here to 7,000 again and keep on going higher. So this is definitely bullish in nature. I don't know where Slovakia, we're going to skip that one. Russia, with all the drama that's going on worldwide, this is still consolidating, believe it or not. It's bearish in the consolidation, where the resistance is right here at 31, 3311, which is the top of the consolidation pattern. And the bottom, believe it or not, is roughly around here, around 2900, 2950 is the bottom. But you could see the bottoms are slowly, the supports are going lower and lower and lower. So this consolidation pattern is starting to get tighter and tighter and tighter to a point it could explode one way or another. But you would think with all the stuff that's going on in Russia, the markets are crashing, but they're not. South Africa, Here, you could see a nice little bullish trend now consolidating at the top. It's going for its first major pullback. Question is, how far will it go? Major resistance level for this guy to sit there and hold a major pullback level is going to be 10,600. What we're predicting right now is this to pull back up to 10,600, hold it, and then start to make a move down to possibly get back down to about 9,000 is what we're predicting the price pattern to be. If it breaks the major resistance level, then there's high probability it's going to retest the high 11,198. Now we're going to move over to Turkey and slowly start going into the Middle East. If you look at Turkey, really not doing anything except consolidating here. We bounce at the top of the consolidation pattern, which is 4669. And if you look at it here, we kind of bounced off it, came deck down in here. This is still bullish, believe it or not. It's a bullish consolidation pattern, so be very careful of this one in how you play it, but it is still bullish in a consolidation pattern going up. Israel, this had some nice momentum to the upside. Finally, in the last couple of weeks, it's decided it's going to give up some and pull back a little. This is not much of a major pullback. It still has not gone for a major pullback at all. We're at a critical support right now, which is going to be around 60.47. If we sit there and close below that, then we have a possibility of getting 58.53, which is the line in the sand, determine if we're going to go for a major pullback or not. But this minor support looks like it's holding so far. If it does, it's going to make a move back up to its resistance level 63.79, and possibly could break it and keep on going higher. So this is still a very strong bullish trend right now. It's showing some signs of weakness, but not too much, believe it or not. Saudi Arabia was one of the countries that's pretty much been leading worldwide in a nice trend, and you could see last 2 weeks, even though it's a little movements up, it's still going up. So Saudi Arabia right now is still showing the biggest momentum out there, and you could see that after it broke 10,000, this thing has been on a vengeance going up, and it's still very strong. You could see that even from the daily time frame. Dubai, showing some signs of weakness here. Still has not gone for a major pullback at all. 5,001 is going to be a major resistance level. If it holds it, it possibly can go for a major pullback. To go for a major pullback, it's got to sit there and break 4,328, which is a support level. Abu Dhabi, you could see here is a nice bullish trend here. It's pulled back, but not a major pullback at all. Major resistance level is 5,173, and the 40, can't even see that value. Let me enlarge this. 4,751 is going to dictate whether it's going to go for a pullback or not. That's the critical support level for that particular market, which is Abu Dhabi. Bahrain, you could see a nice little bullish trend here. It's continuing to go up. 14,252 is a minor support, but that's very strong compared to Dubai and Abu Dhabi, but not as strong as Saudi Arabia. Kuwait here, nice little bullish trend here. Held a major support level, which was right here at 1142. Bounce off there and getting to a major resistance level at 1208. If it could break 1208, then it's going to have a chance to keep on going higher. We believe it's going to hit 1208, bounce off there, come back down to about 1183, and that's going to be its major test level to determine if this thing is going to continue to go higher or it's going to start entering, start and breaking the supports to go for a major pullback. Oman. Here, this is still bullish trending, still really has not gone for a major pullback at all. Major resistance level 7468, major support level 7092. Qatar, here, this is bullish trending here, still has not gone for a major pullback at all either. A major resistance level, which it's approaching, is 13,696, and support on this guy is going to be 12,676. If you break that support, then we have a possibility of starting a major trend to the downside. Okay, let's transition to Asia. Let's look at China. And you could see China here, after it held the support here, it's kind of blown up and gone up. Believe it or not, this is still a consolidation pattern. The bottom of the consolidation pattern, which we outlined, was roughly around 21.32, and the top is roughly going to be around 23.76. So we're getting to the top of the consolidation pattern now. This is a bullish consolidation pattern where the lows are going higher and the highs are going higher. So we're kind of expecting price to at least get back up to 23.76 before it could break down. If it doesn't break down, it's going to break through that and start a trend to the outside where it's going to break this consolidation pattern. But what we're expecting is a pullback right now to about 22.47, and then it make its move to go back up. If we see that, then this has a possibility of breaking out of the consolidation pattern. So the key levels right now that we're looking at is 22.47 for the support and 23.76 for the resistance. So those are the two levels that we're looking for the Chinese market to determine whether we're going to still stay in that consolidation pattern or to break out. If you remember, we talked about a pairs trade of basically going long Hong Kong and shorting China. And you could see here, Hong Kong has broken out of the resistance here and gone to the next resistance level, which is 24.90. And the next one after that is going to be 26.238. This is in a nice little trend going up, and it still has a lot of strength. So as China keeps on pushing upwards, you're going to see Hong Kong definitely get to its next level. But this is still very, very strong, stronger than China, believe it or not. Korea, so that's one pairs trade. Another one you could do is go long Hong Kong and short Chinese market as another pairs trade, a quarterly pairs trade strategy. Korea, you could see here, this is consolidating. It is a bullish consolidation pattern where resistance is 272.80 and the support's around 258, but it's a bullish consolidation pattern. Japan, this was a nice little trend up. However, it sat there and broke this low resistance level here and came pulled back down here. So this is now starting to establish a consolidation pattern. The key thing that we have to see is what's going to happen here at this resistance level right here at 14,759. If it holds that resistance level, this is not going to be a consolidation pattern. This is going to undergo a major pullback work, at least get down to about 13,000 or maybe even lower in the 12,000 range. If it breaks that resistance level, then it's going to sit there and go higher and start entering a consolidation pattern where you're going to have roughly the top of the consolidation pattern is going to be around 16,000. So this is going to be interesting to see exactly what happens. But right now, we're kind of in this critical range right here to determine what's going to happen with the Japanese market. Malaysia, bullish trending here, starting to show some weakness here at the top. Major support right here is 18.33, which is a major support. So I'll definitely be very careful in going long in the Malaysian market right now because it's starting to show some weakness. If it breaks that support, 18.33, we're definitely going to enter a major pullback. So definitely keep an eye on that one. Singapore. If you look at the Singapore market, it's bullish trending here, held a major support level at 60.38, and now back at a major resistance of 61.81. If it breaks this resistance, which it has a high probability of doing, then this is going to continue to trend longer. If it doesn't hold that resistance, it's going to come back to 60.38 and then sit there and try to make a move to the major support, which is going to be 59.26. If it gets to 59.62 and breaks that, then it's going to undergo a major pullback down to 55.16. So very, very critical levels right now are the 60.38 and 61.81. If it breaks that resistance, it's going to keep on going higher. If it breaks the 60.38, this is going to enter a major pullback, possibly enter a major pullback. Thailand, remember Thailand, Philippines, Indonesia were pretty much showing very, very similar signs. Thailand here, and let's show you where they were bullish trending. They basically pulled back and were consolidating on the major pullback levels. And you could see here, this is the trending here. This is the pullback here, and now this is starting to make a move to come back up. Now, a lot of people think it's going to come back and retest this high after a major pullback. There's no guarantees on that. You could sit there and make lower highs, believe it or not. So this is very, very dangerous zone here where you have to be very careful where you're trying to predict this to go higher. This is approaching a major resistance level of 1555. It can sit there at that point, bounce off there and make lower highs and enter a consolidation pattern. So be very careful. If you're in any trades, tighten up your stops for the Thailand market. Indonesia, you could see it's approached pretty much the pivot high here. unlike the Thailand market. So this is strong compared to the Thailand market, and you could see we're approached to here. So we could sit there, hold this resistance level at that one. There's low probability, believe it or not, to break to 5238. If we do, then basically this is going to continue to trend a lot higher and a lot faster if we break that level. So watch out for this level here, because this is probably going to show some signs of slowing down very soon. Next is going to be Philippines. And you can see the Philippines has not really done anything compared to the Thailand and Indonesia market. So this is the weakest of those that will pretty much fall in the same chart pattern. So this is another pairs trade you possibly can do, is short the Philippines market, and believe it or not, go long Thailand or go long Indonesia. Because if when they start reversing in these Southeast West countries, this is probably going to be the first one that goes down to the bearish side. And you can see here it's stuck around a resistance at 42.16 and nowhere near close to its major pivot high, which basically dictated everything going on. So this one is definitely looked to see goes first. And if it breaks its 40.91 level, this definitely is going to sit there and start reversing to get back down here to this level here, and possibly can reverse or it'll enter a consolidation pattern. Vietnam, really not doing anything here. Major trend pulled back. It pulled back too much, so it's high probability of consolidating. Stopped at a resistance here at 20,769. So it's at a critical resistance level right now. India, we've been talking about this being bullish, and you could see this is still very, very strong bullish, even though it's consolidating here. This minor support level, it's following up this minor support level, and it's right against a major resistance of 26,083. And believe it or not, it has a high probability of breaking that and continuing to go higher and a next leg to keep on going higher. So definitely keep an eye on the Indian market, but there's no signs of weakness as of right now. Australia. This is bullish trending. Still really hasn't gone for a major pullback at all. Major support level now is going to be 54.21. If it closes below there, then we're going to sit there and enter a major pullback where it possibly can come all the way down to the 5,000 level. But this support level is holding, and it looks like it's trying to break this resistance at 55.26. If it does, it's going to sit there and get down to go all the way up to 58.07 and slowly approaching 6,000. It seems like by the end of this year, if it could sit there and start a trend to another level. New Zealand is next. New Zealand, you could see here, is bullish trending, hit a major roadblock at 51.88, and then the major support is going to be roughly around 49.43. If it breaks that support, it's going to enter a major pullback. But this is still very, very strong, believe it or not. So don't give out on this one. But it's still very, very strong. Okay, so let's go to North and South America. Let's start with the US markets. Let's look at the Dow. There's a lot of support resistance levels in here. Believe it or not, we actually put out a video last week when the markets were going down. We said, and a lot of people were on TV were talking about it going bearish and all this stuff, and a lot of people were panicked. We said, don't panic. We actually laid out all the support resistances in that videos. If you want, you can find them on Twitter or YouTube, or you could actually go to our blog off Ichimoku Trading and can see those videos. And believe it or not, our support resistance levels for even day trading and swing trading that we've been posting on Twitter have been perfect, spot on within a couple of ticks. But this still is bullish. It will remain bullish here. 16,504 is a major support right now, which it held and looks like it's trying to go up. It's got a major resistance level right now it's abutting against, which is 16,751. If it breaks that, then it's got a high probability coming up. So you could see the Dow is still very strong, where it's basically respecting the cadence in the green line. S&P here, you could see here is still very strong here. This here pulled back up to the support level, roughly around 1900, and then kind of held that level to go up. So this is still very strong going up. It's at a minor resistance level, which is at 19,451, which is the same as the Dow. So notice the Dow and the S&P are at minor resistance levels right now. NASDAQ here, you could see is different. Because it really didn't pull back that much compared to the Dow and the S&P. So this is probably the strongest of all the US markets right now. We're right against a major resistance level of 39.92. If we break that, we're going to keep on going higher. But the NASDAQ is still very, very strong compared to all the other three markets. Next is going to be Canada. If you look at Canada, this is still very strong bullish. Major support level, sorry, support level is going to be 15,105, which we're kind of holding, respecting. So it does have a high probability of getting to 15,444 and continuous trend up, because this is still very, very strong, believe it or not. Next, it's going to be Mexico. Mexico here, as you could see, it's kind of in a consolidation pattern here. But if we shrink this down, you could kind of see it's not really. Really, this is a nice little trend here. It pulled back. This is the major pullback here. The major pullback then entered a consolidation pattern, finally broke out of that consolidation pattern, and now it's trying to retest this high up here. And you could see it's trying to retest the high. Now, the question is, will it retest the high or fall short of it? Fall short of it will be roughly at this resistance here at 44,688. So we're at a major resistance level right now where we have to kind of see what's going to happen here. So only time's going to tell in the next couple of weeks. Argentina, where everyone's talking about default and all this, look at this market. This thing is still very, very strong going up. And you could see it held a minor support at 80.25 and starting to make a move to the highs again at 80.80. And believe it or not, if it gets there, it's going to have a high probability of breaking it, because they held a minor support and still has a chance of going up. So Argentina is still very, very strong bullish. Remember, this led all world markets last year with 103% return, and it's continuing its journey up. It's second to basically Saudi Arabia right now, believe it or not. Santiago, Chile, nothing really exciting here. Nice little bearish trend here. It's finally gone for its major pullback level right now. Pullback levels, it could go all the way up to about 39.63, which it's been holding, but the major one, it still can possibly go up to 40.69 before it decides it wants to come back and try to retest this low here. But this pullback is a consolidation pullback, so it's looking very ugly right now. Brazil, which a lot of people have been talking about being bullish, and you could see here, and let me do this, just enlarge this guy right there. You could see here, this is a nice little trend going down, kind of held the support here, and now trying to break out. There's high probability, believe it or not, this is going to break out and go higher. High probability at least getting to 65.74, because this is showing very strong signs of being bullish, and even possibly breaking the 64.547 level. And we're going to keep on watching that all the way up to August 25th. There's timing elements right now which are going to go against this bullish momentum to August 25th. After August 25th, there's no timing elements to go against it. If this thing decides to break this pivot high within these bearish timing elements, believe it or not, this is going to be very strong to a point it could break the 60,574. So this is definitely one I'll keep an eye on for the next couple of weeks, because this has the biggest potential pop, believe it or not, to make a move, and it's just about to begin. Okay. So we pretty much have completed all the global markets out there. If you guys have any questions, feel free to contact us. This is something everyone should be noticing, especially on the US side. Some of the people have been asking me, how do you trade these markets if we can't really trade the indexes? But there's ETFs that are represent these global markets, believe it or not, in the US Stock Exchange. And then on our website, we actually call them international ETFs. So if you go to our website, ichimokutrade.com, under the heat map, look up international ETFs, and you can see all the ETFs that are related to all these different international countries. So you could trade those at different international countries directly for those ETFs. They may not be completely directly correlated, but they're very, very similar. And you could even do pairs trading based on those ETFs too. And just like we've been talking about going long Germany, going short Paris, and then we've been talking about other countries doing that, so forth. Hope you enjoy the video. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us. Thank you.